book.
Oh, it's been a while. Why are you doing this?
It's a tough gig being a hard-boiled depression-era detective in the 21st century. The name's Nate Salt, Private Eye. I keep the scum off the streets. Or keep it on, provided I see a pretty penny coming my way. There are only three things in this world that I trust. My Magnum, my legal tender, and my partner, Colby Valencia. Gets sharp. I'd be needing him for this case.
Dames.
Chloe?
Oh, Nathan!
What happened this time?
Somebody killed my husband!
Oh, again?
Yes.
What is that, third time this month?
I stabbed him in the heart, I saw it. Please find him.
Find who?
Ace Jackson.
Hey, what's going on here?
Another dead husband.
Again?
Yeah, you know, usual business.
That's tough.
Take her home, Valencia.
All right, let's get you home, you're a mess. What you need is a stiff drink.
So what about payment?
Thank you.
About pay... God
damn. That third time this month comment was hardly exaggeration. That was Chloe Loretta Ryan. Classy broad, but she could be a crazy dame with the best of them. Every couple of weeks, she'd come to me with these odd jobs. Didn't matter what they were, though, I'd still do them. Never paid me either, but for some reason, that didn't really matter to me.
Oh, hey, it's Chloe.
Wonder what she's doing here.
Chloe, what are you doing here?
Just taking some time off of my job as a nurse to relax.
Nurse? I thought you were a secretary.
That's what I meant to say.
Either way, it works.
Yeah.
Shouldn't be out here, it's cold.
True.
Get yourself a need to relax.
Guess
that
I should.
Dead husbands.
Right.
Alright, well, we're working on your case.
Thank you.
We'll get to the bottom of this.
Thank you. Okay.
I don't buy it.
No way Canessa killed her husband.
Isn't that our man?
That's Ace. Let's get him.
Thank you.
What do we know about Jackson?
At least another private eye, but...
Why would he be following Chloe? Is he trying to knock her off too?
Maybe trying to finish the job.
Who could he be working for?
Don't know. That's what we gotta find out.
Put out some feelings on some of my informants. Trying to figure out who this Jackson guy's working for.
Keep an eye on Chloe, make sure she's alright.
I need to. Who knows who's out there?
Don't worry, I'm packing heat.
With that, we split up for a few days. While Valencia kept Chloe out of trouble, I hit the books on this Jackson guy. He was a hard fellow to pin down, and ended up finding only one source. His name was William Mays. He knew a guy who knew a guy who I threw in the slammer once. I knew it would be a fun meeting. You William Mays?
Maybe.
You got the information?
You got the money? What about a full octet?
Your ass will never be.
Alright, whoa, wait, back off. Back off.
Let's take a walk. So, you know who he's working for?
Well, I can't tell you his employer, but I can tell you. Tonight. You know the pub at 4th and Franklin? Let's just say he has an obsession with moonshine.
You're a good man, Maze. Take it easy.
With the info I picked up from Maze, there was only one thing left to do. Call Valencia and have a chat with Mr. Jackson. I just hope tonight wouldn't be too late.
You again?
Nathan!
Chloe, what are you doing?
I had to confront him. You killed my husband.
I did nothing of the sort.
You did, I saw you.
She lies.
Shut up.
I've been trailing her for days. I have proof.
What's going on here?
Hey, guys. Tell you what, I'll settle this now.
And it finally came to this.
Oh, Nathan.
Chloe?
What the hell did you do, Valencia?
She was trying to stab you. Look at the knife.
She killed her husband. She tried to kill you, too.
Case closed.
Let's go.
I did a bit more snooping on Chloe. It seems that this wasn't the first time she's done this kind of thing. She usually came out of it alive. As it turns out, my Chloe was a bit of a serial killer. She'd gone through 6 husbands by the time she made it to me. 6. All the same way. Take what she could get and stick with the poor bastards until there wasn't anything left, then knife them. Leave a mess for the fuzz to clean up. She seemed like a nice enough girl, but when the nice enough girl tries to stab you, I guess that's just the way things go. There ain't no bonds out there that last forever.